Hi, my name is Tim Grasso, and I would like to welcome you to the second half of our eBook introduction on behalf of Fuller's David Allen Hubbard Library. The key points we're going to cover include: how do you find eBooks? How do you open and read eBooks online? How do you download an eBook offline? Now we're going to go to the library website, and I'm going to show you where and how to find an eBook. Here on the library website, I'm conducting a search for a Bible commentary on the Book of James. This search pulls up a number of different items in the library catalog, over 6,000 results. If you wanted to narrow down search results, you can use the many search facets available here on the left side of the screen. To start, we can limit results to Fuller-owned library items by clicking Fuller Libraries. We can then further limit to Fuller-owned eBooks by clicking eBooks under Format. If I wanted to eliminate older research, I could restrict results to works published in the last 25 years here under Publication Year. With these facets added, our results are now under 100. Now let's say we didn't want to find just any James commentary, but we wanted to find the commentary explicitly in the Baker Exegetical Commentary of the New Testament. By typing in Baker Exegetical, we see that James is the commentary we are looking for, and it's the first result. So starting from the library website, you can search with keywords, and then use facets to expand or limit your results. So let's talk about how you would actually open an ebook, and the different options available. Since these results are both Fuller-owned ebooks, they all have a View eBook access link. Anytime you see the blue View eBook button, you will know that some Fuller accessible full text is associated with that item. Full text simply means that the actual textual content of the book is visible, rather than just a citation record. But not all the links are exactly the same. Those entries with an outgoing arrow have only one eBook link. Clicking View eBook will take you directly to the database with the eBook text. The entries with the downward arrow have multiple eBook links to different databases. We see this eBook has links to both eBook Central by ProQuest and EBSCO, our two biggest eBook providers. The same information is visible within an item's detailed record. You can view detailed information by clicking on an item's title. All of the available eBook links are listed under Access Online. The main View eBook link takes you to the first link on the list. Now if you click a link and it doesn't work or takes you to the wrong eBook, you can quickly get assistance by clicking Report a Broken Link button within the item record, or the link drop-down on the search results page. So now we're actually going to open and view an eBook through the EBSCO database. When you click View eBook, you will be prompted to sign in with your Fuller username and password if you are not already signed in. Once you're signed in, you will see that there is a lot of information on this page, but we're going to focus on what you need to know to view and download eBooks. We can see some relevant information here under Publisher Permissions and User Level. This lets us know that you can only download 12 pages at a time in standard PDF, and that only one user can view the eBook online at a time. When you have single-user eBooks like this one, full eBook downloads will not be available. The majority of library eBooks do not limit the number of online users and are downloadable, but newer commentaries and other reference works often do have this restriction. To view an eBook online in EBSCO or ProQuest, there are two main access options. You can access the full text from the beginning in PDF or EPUB formats, or you can use the hyperlinked table of contents to open the eBook at a specific location. The primary difference between formats is that PDF eBooks support page-level citations through fixed page numbers, where EPUB allows resizing of text to best fit your screen and offers increased accessibility. Most eBooks are only offered in one of the formats, but it does help to know the pros and cons between them. Let's go ahead and open the full text in PDF. You will now again have access to the eBook contents on the left and can scroll through the whole eBook display on the right. If desired, you can minimize the contents table here. Although this eBook does not allow for a full download, you can still download up to 12 pages as a PDF. You can do this through either the chapter download icons listed here, or through the Save Pages icon at the top. You can choose to download the whole chapter or section, the current page, or any specific number of pages. That is a good way to hit your maximum number of downloadable pages. A regular PDF download does not require an account or non-standard software, and never expires. Now we're going to quickly switch to a second EBSCO eBook, so that we can show you how to do a full eBook download. You can start a full download, either on the main record page here, or when viewing online, in the upper right corner by clicking Full Download. When you click Full Download, you will be prompted to sign into a My EBSCOhost account. The My EBSCOhost account is different from your Fuller ID. If you do not already have a My EBSCOhost account, you can create one by clicking Create One Now under Sign In. Once you click Sign In and have your account created, you will be given a download dialog box. You will be required to check that you have Adobe Digital Editions, or ADE, installed on your computer. Please do not download an ebook before installing ADE, as this can cause data issues for you later on. Once that is installed, confirm your desired checkout time and click Full Download. This downloads an encrypted ACSM file, which when selected is opened in ADE. If your computer does not display downloads, you may need to find the file in your downloads folder. Once it opens in ADE, you now have access to the entire ebook offline. Once your ebook has downloaded, you can return to the ADE library by clicking Library at the top left corner. From here, you can right-click to return a borrowed item, or to remove an expired item from your library. Please note that when an ebook expires or is returned, it will not retain any notes or highlighting when you download it again. This concludes our live ebook demonstration. So to quickly review, we learned how to find and search for ebooks in the library catalog, how to open and view ebook links from the catalog and report broken links, how to read full-text EBSCO and ProQuest ebooks online in different formats, and lastly, how to download both PDF chapters and entire EBSCO eBooks using Adobe Digital Editions. Thanks for watching the second half of our eBook overview, and be sure to learn more about EBSCO and ProQuest research tools and annotation features in our advanced eBook tutorial. Please feel free to email electronic resources at lib-systems@fuller.edu if you have any questions. Thank you again, and happy reading.